I went for a walk today at Fair Hill, getting my, you know, hiking on. Most of the areas, there wasn't many cicada shells around. We went through one area though that you could just hear them humming. It sounded like a car alarm was going off, is what I kind of liken it to, above us everywhere. When we went on a walk yesterday, it always sounded like the cicadas were in the distance, and we thought that they would just stop talking or stop their buzzing when we were nearby. But no, today they were like all around us in this one spot we went through. And that was a pretty wild experience. And you could see them. Some of them were falling out of trees randomly. Anyway, that was awesome. And then my dad and I walked the drive and we beat back a lot of the brush because the brush grows very quickly in the spring, obviously. And so I took like massive shears. They extend to probably like 10 feet long. And so yeah, I was like going and doing so much. And I felt so like strong and powerful as I was going down through there, like lopping stuff off. And it takes like all your body weight to, anyway. I felt very strong and powerful, so that was like an empowering moment for me to be a badass woman who doesn't need anybody. I did need my dad's moral support though, just to, you know, be with me, but it's fine. But our driveway is a quarter of a mile long, by the way. It's not like I'm doing like a tiny driveway, like it's a quarter of a mile long, so it's really long. I'm really, really appreciating these weekend times now that I can take time off like that to go and take a walk and hike, and that was amazing. And that's one of my goals for the summer, right, is to go for more hikes. So I'm really appreciating that time. And I also got another job offer for Schoolyard Ventures to work on their summer SIP program, which would start in not this week, but the following week. And so I have to look at my schedule and make a decision on that if I want to commit, because right now I really like my schedule and I have it. So a lot of evenings I have off and I have weekends off right now and have that free time and that rest time to pursue passion projects and pursue like health stuff and recharging. And so I need to decide, obviously, if I say yes to one thing, I'm saying no to something else. And so I need to decide like what's in the cards for me? What do I want to do? But obviously I'm so passionate about mentoring and about Schoolyard Ventures and their different programs. And so I think I'm going to say yes to one, but yeah. So anyway, we'll see. I will keep you all updated. Okay. Bye. So I'm doing some more Marie Kondo organizing today, going through the rest of my socks. The other day I had some socks down here in the closet that is right there, and then the rest of my socks were upstairs in my room, and I'm gonna consolidate them all into one sock thing. But I have an entire drawer to go through, get rid of socks that I don't use anymore, and then obviously organize them using the Marie Kondo method. So let's do it. So this is what we have so far. This is the drawer from my room on the other side. I brought it down because I wanted to do it down here. So these are all of the socks that I have to go through, reorganize, get rid of ones that I don't need anymore. All right, let's do it. Aurora is trying to help. Can you not? Can you not? I'm trying to organize that, thank you very much. And you're kind of in the way. All right, you silly little lady. Scat, scat, cat, come on, scat, scat. No, don't make yourself at home. What did I say? I said scat. Oh my God. What a weirdo, what a weirdo. You're so cute though, you're so cute though. But annoying. Really annoying. So we've officially cleaned it out. These are my regular going out socks. There's like a line here, and these are my home socks, and then these are my little footy socks. This is the pile of giving away socks that I will not be keeping, which actually there are quite a number there. So I'm very proud of myself. These are the two maybes, and yeah, it's coming together. So let's put them in. It's the other sock drawer that I'm gonna add to that one. Can you not with this one too? These are clean. Don't do it. So yeah, we're gonna add them together now. Let's do it. So here is my sock drawer. We've got some little spaces here because these are not all my socks. These are the clean socks. Aurora, this is not your moment. So this is the sock drawer after. You remember the before picture? This is the after. It is so exciting. Everything looks so much neater. It is coming together well. So we had the second to last Achievement House meeting today with our students that we've been with for almost a year, and it was definitely kind of bittersweet just because these students will be going on and one's graduating, and you know, they'll be going on and doing other things, and we won't, you know, see them twice a week. And so we did some gratitudes and appreciations, which I love that that's something that Schoolyard Ventures does. They do that for their SAP program, and so we did that for this program as well. They just light up with a smile on their face the whole time that you're giving them words of affirmation and just gratitudes and appreciations. appreciations for everything that they've done over the past, you know, 9 months. So that is just such a positive, incredible experience. And I really have been reflecting on it and how much I've seen these students grow. I mean, one of the students, you know, the very first day was like really shy, like almost hiding his face on Zoom. And then every week now, after 9 months, you know, we have conversations and talk for like an hour. And so that's just been incredible. And then obviously one of the students did my banner and my logo for this YouTube channel. And so that was just really, really special to have him, you know, help me out. And I learned so much. He's like a YouTube genius. And I was learning all this stuff about YouTube that I didn't know from him. And so that's just been an incredible journey. And so I was reflecting a lot on that today, and it's been really amazing. And then the SIP program, I am going to be a mentor for their summer program, which starts next week, which I'm really, really excited about. So I will be mentoring for the second time with their SIP program. I'm also working on Spur Impact. I'm doing my internship hours today. I'm working more on the mentoring program, really filling that in, getting really deep into the details. So it's been a lot of fun working on that internship time today too. So yeah, it's gonna be a fun rest of the day. Let's get to it. So I am currently working on a logo for the Spur Impact Mentoring Program, which we are actually, the name of it was simple, Spur Impact Mentoring Program Learning Experience. Now it's going to be, because that was just very ironic and it was a funny placeholder until we found something better, but I came up with a better name, Impact Mentoring, and I am so, so freaking excited for that new name. So I'm currently working on a logo. Let me show you what I have so far. I am just playing around with a lot of different stuff. These are my top three word choices so far. I'm still working on it. I took that inspiration and I've just been playing around. I don't have the exact color code of what that is, so I'm just playing around randomly with creating something that would be similar but different enough. So that was my inspiration for that. I'd love a similar symbol to this. This is three though, which is kind of giving me pause because obviously mentoring is one-on-one mentoring. But this one just feels like there's something missing, so I haven't figured that out yet. I was also playing around with these type of like, almost like stamps, like impact mentoring, you know, very exciting. So anyway, we're working on it, but this is what I have so far, and we'll just continue to play with it until I get inspired and find the real thing. All right, so this is where we have progressed to. So I created a bunch of different symbols using stuff from the internet as inspiration, and I'm not really sure what I like best. Obviously, I think I like this one best, but mentoring is usually two people. So again, I'm not really sure. This one's too like aggressive. They're colliding almost. So I'm not really sure what to do with this, but then I was playing around with different fonts and different kind of spacing of it as well. This one I did, some are lowercase, some are uppercase, some are together, some had spaces. And so I've just been playing around with that and seeing what I can do. And so yeah, still a lot of ideas coming. It is still so nice out. I know I keep saying that, but I'm just so appreciating this beautiful weather. Anyway, what I came out to tell you about was that I won a Diana Award from the UK Diana Award organization. My mentor Ryan Sanders nominated me, and so I just recorded a bunch of videos, four different videos for them. They're having a virtual awards ceremony, and it was really funny because they had four different videos. One of them was you introducing yourself and saying what you do, and then another video was like a manifesto. It was kind of almost like a poem, and then you would just read off the poem, and then another one was like, you know, young people can change the world or something. And then the final video was literally just a countdown from 30. And you know how many times it took me to record that specific video? Too many. I kept skipping numbers. What the heck? It was so funny. I was like, oh yeah, that was a good one. That felt good. And I would watch it back, skipped 11, skipped 21. Like, I don't know why, but the ones were not good for me today. So freaking hilarious. So I'll put some of the bloopers in here of that because it was really cracking me up. I was like, you would think this would be the easiest thing. I just say, you know, 30, 29, 20. No, so hard. 24, 23, 21, 13, 12, 10. But anyway, I'm really, really honored and very excited to be a part of the Diana Award now and to be receiving one. So thank you to Ryan for nominating me for that award. I'm so, so excited for the virtual awards ceremony. But anyway, I just thought that was funny and I wanted to share. Let me set you down here. Oop, too low. Way too low. And yeah, Again, not in focus. What is that? What is that?
All right, so we got some weird speckled shadows going on here. I don't know if I like it, but we'll just go for it. It's definitely starting to get hotter. It's like in the 90s every day now. Feels like golden hour. Look at all of that. Oh, there's like no weird bad angles. This is great. Anyway.